Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.
Good evening and welcome to the Berks County Kennel Club's program, All About Dogs. Hi, I'm Pat Mock, your host, and this evening we have a new breed for you. It was just recognized by the AKC in 2021?
January 2021.
2021, okay. So it's a whole new breed. So I'll introduce my guests first. By the way, the breed is a Biewer Terrier. We'll talk about that later. So my guest next to me is Donna
DeMers.
DeMers, okay. And next to her is Teresa Cuchiaro. Cuchiaro, okay. I'll eventually get one of them straight. I know Marilyn Faughner, so I got her name right. And her friend Stephanie. And at the end, we have Karen Duprat.
Yes.
Right. So three of these ladies are from Massachusetts. So they came all this way just to show you their beautiful dogs. And aren't they adorable? They were at a show this past weekend up in New Jersey, correct?
Yes.
Edison, New Jersey.
Yes, Edison.
Right, right. And it was a toy dog specialty up there?
Thursday night was
a toy dog specialty.
The Delaware Valley.
Okay.
Toy Dog Association.
Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah. So it was a specialty up there as well. So there must have been lots of little guys up there. Right. Right. So first of all, this is a Biewer Terrier, but it is spelled, wait a minute, we have a sign. There you go. That is how it is spelled. B-I-E-W-E-R instead of this way. But that's how most people say it, that way. But it's actually this. So don't look up on AKC website a beaver, B-E-A-V-E-R, and expect to find the breed, because you're not going to. Anyhow, where did this breed come from?
Germany.
Mr.
Biewer is the one that developed it.
Mr. Biewer. Okay.
Yes.
Okay, very good. And he developed this for what purpose?
Companion.
Oh, just strictly a companion?
Yes.
Okay.
In 1983 is when he started playing with the breed,
Oh, okay.
Developing the breed.
Okay, okay. And it's bred true then for all these years. That, do you know what he used to develop the breed?
The story is that he took the Yorkies that had the white spot on their chest.
Okay.
Which is a piebald gene.
Yes.
And he would breed those together, and that is what supposedly developed this breed.
Oh, okay. But they look smaller than the Yorkies. No? Am I wrong?
They're actually bigger. They're actually larger, I think, than
really?
That.
And if
when
you
get...
the standard is 4 to 8 as compared to 4 to 7.
And if you go back to the original lines, those dogs were even bigger.
Yes. Yes. So it was bred for nothing other than pretty.
Yes.
And to sit on your lap kind of thing,
yes.
Which obviously all of them are excellent at. So we have ages here from, 11 weeks? Teresa, your babies are 11 weeks. I mean, isn't that cute? These tiny little puppies. And I think the oldest is what, 5?
This one's 5.
5.
She's 2.
She's 2, so I guess 5 is the oldest.
She's 7 months old.
She's 7 months old. Wow.
She's 4 months old.
Oh, she's 4 months old. So you have a whole range of sizes here, or ages. Not really sizes, but ages. But anyhow, so how popular at this point is this breed since it was only recognized in 2020?
You'd be surprised. It's very popular.
Really?
Very, very popular.
Yes. Well, I guess because it's small, but it's also hairy.
Yes.
You know. It has a nice soft coat. I mean, it's a silky coat.
Yes.
It doesn't
softer than a Yorkie would be.
Right, right.
Much softer. It's more like a Maltese coat.
Oh, okay, okay. Do you think he might have thrown some Maltese in? Who knows? Right. Who knows?
No.
Yeah, that's exactly
They
right.
said Maltese, Bichon, and Havanese were worked into the Yorkshire Terrier.
Bichon and Havanese.
Now, I never heard the Bichon, but I did hear the Havanese and the Maltese.
Bichon to get that coat, the whiteness in the coat.
Oh, huh. How about that?
So you still get the double coat.
Yes.
And, who knows where they came from. They're pretty, their coats are pretty straight.
Yes.
So I really question sometimes how much Bichon.
I think it was because Maltese. They have a very curly coat, almost
right.
like a poodle.
Like a poodle.
Mm-hmm. Right. I think it was Maltese.
Maltese. Yes. I would agree. Yeah. Maltese. But all of them blended together with the Yorkie. Mm-hmm.
But you know, even in the beginning, when the Beaver, Mr. and Mrs. Beaver were doing their breedings, they actually would get a litter that was kind of sort of a mixture.
Yes.
Where you might get, you know, one or two, maybe three that had the white on them, but then they would get the more darker colors. Donna's girl, Ivanka, has the darker coat on her saddle,
uh-huh.
like a
right,
you know, like a Yorkshire,
like the Yorkie,
Terry.
right.
So that's where you kind of find the fine line there.
Yeah,
for the
yeah.
standard.
So they can be any color, or they have to be these three colors.
They have to be three colors. They okay. have to have a tricolored face.
Okay.
White legs.
And chest and
white
chin.
White legs and
uh-huh.
the chest.
Uh-huh.
And under their chin.
Oh, okay. But then the body, it doesn't matter whether it's more white, is one more favorable than the other?
They need it to be symmetrical if they can do it. They want it to be on both sides.
Oh,
so,
okay.
But the patent doesn't have to, as long as they have a white strip around their neck,
uh-huh.
and they have the white legs and the white, you know, belly and under
yeah,
their chin.
Yeah, it's a dry-colored face.
Your black and white on the body itself can be anywhere except the legs.
Okay, okay. So
the
then
black can't be on the legs.
They actually call this black, not gray. It's almost like, well, with the marbling of the hair, it almost
this
looks like
this one is turning blue, what is called
oh,
blue.
Oh, okay.
Some can turn blue.
Uh-huh.
And that is in our standards also.
Oh, okay. Wow. So are these dogs easy to train? I mean, housebreaking. Since they are toy dogs, it's always easier to train a big dog than it is a little dog because they have such tiny little bladders.
Well,
so
this little
depends.
11-week-old is already trained to
okay.
go on paper in the house.
Okay, okay. Which I assume most of you have, right?
Right.
Paper in the house.
Mm-hmm.
That,
mm-hmm. I don't.
Oh.
My litters of puppies,
mm-hmm.
They get trained on the potty trays. So you put the
okay.
scented
okay.
pad in.
Yes.
And actually, I have found the last couple litters that I've had, mom's pretty much done all the training. So by 8.5, 9 weeks old, when I send these puppies home, they're all potty trained to the tray.
Oh.
An accident here, maybe an accident there.
Yeah, yeah.
But I started very early, and what I've found is when I've gotten dogs from other breeders that keep paper like all over their pens,
mm-hmm.
for example, they get used to the smell of living with urine, living
yes.
with feces.
Yes.
So we try to keep that paper in one spot or
right.
those trays
right.
in one spot. So they're drawn to go there
yes.
as opposed to going everywhere.
Anywhere you want.
Right.
And
right.
I think if you, you know, if they're brought up in a clean environment, I think Teresa would agree with me.
Right.
That
they don't like to be dirty.
It's easier to keep that.
Mm-hmm.
And it's real easy to go from the trays, which have the pad underneath, outside for them to be
okay.
able to go. Now she'll start to bark and whine in the carts if she needs to go to the bathroom.
Oh, okay, okay.
But I mean, I think it depends on your diligence,
mm-hmm.
as with any toy dog.
Yeah,
yes.
I still think that one of the drawbacks of some of the small dogs is
mm-hmm.
house training. Because when you ask them, is the dog house trained? And they'll say, oh yeah, oh, you might have a little accident
uh-huh.
here or there.
Right,
well,
right.
if that was a golden, you would
right,
be saying
right,
there's a
yes.
river. That's
yeah,
not house
it's
trained.
It's not a little accident any longer.
And
right.
it's one of the reasons many of the dogs are returned. They can't get them house trained and they don't want to live that way. So
okay.
it is one of the
See,
issues.
Anna, I've had a lot of requests for oh my God, what do I do? How do I do this schedule? And I always tell them, just like I used to tell my patients in the hospital, you had a life before this baby came home, so you had a life before this puppy comes home.
Mm-hmm.
You need to make that puppy fit into your schedule.
Yes.
So I will give them now a sample time schedule of
uh-huh.
like, you know, roughly.
Right, right, right.
And then I have that on one spot. And then I let on the top half of the paper, and then they can fold it in the bottom, and they can put in
their
times
okay.
for, you know, first thing out.
Yes, yes.
You know, potty break,
right,
eat,
right.
Potty break kind of thing.
Right, that's
and
an excellent
have,
idea.
I've had really good feedback from my puppy owners and said that it made it very happy, you know, very easy. Now, I do know that the ones that I, the litter I it just sent scared. Home, they completely transitioned to go outside, yes, in a matter of like 2 weeks.
Yes, wow, that's wonderful. Yeah. That's great, that's great.
But, you know, as breeders, Teresa can tell you, when you do all that work to get them ready to go home, of course, they're, I'm tired. I'm
yes.
tired.
Sure.
When they go, you know.
Yeah. Now, how big a litter do they have?
Some
two,
can have six,
four?
Some can have three, some can have two.
Right.
Occasionally you'll get a single
litter. A litter of four.
A litter of four.
Most of them have
Is
four.
Is that how many there were, Teresa, in yours?
Four. Yes, four.
Most have four.
Yeah.
I think that's a good average.
Yeah, that's a nice size litter. That's a
you
nice
know, I think
litter.
You're looking at if you get in six or seven puppies, unless you have a girl that's
bigger.
You know, larger to the older standards. So she's at the top of the standard,
yes.
like the 8-inch, you know,
right, right.
8-pound kind of thing and a little taller. They've got more ability to carry more puppies.
Yeah.
Mia was 8 pounds and she gave me two litters of six. So
wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. So imagine how tired the mamas are. You complain how tired are the mamas.
It's true. It is very true.
Yes. So as far as grooming, these dogs obviously at least once a day, if not more, correct?
Correct.
Correct.
But it's only a little dog, so when you're sitting in the evening watching television, it's easy to plop them on your lap and just comb through them.
Right. And I mean, Donna has a bunch at home. I have dogs at home. But for me, the show dogs, I bathe twice a week.
Okay.
So they get a full groom then. And I'll be very honest when I say I don't have to fuss with the coats in between.
Right, right.
Occasionally, but not usually.
Yeah,
usually,
yeah.
They're pretty good.
Well,
I
think
because they're clean.
Yes, right. Because they're clean.
Yes,
right.
If you keep it clean, it's much more manageable. In fact, you should not try to brush them unless they're clean.
Right.
Because that breaks the hair.
Yeah.
Right.
A dirty coat is much harder to get through. And Stephanie has a little girl here who's laying on the floor sleeping, and she's cut down. I'm assuming that is a pet cut for most people, although she does. Can you pick her up?
Mm-hmm. She got her little pony. No.
Now, what do they call this thing? An Asian fusion?
Yes.
An Asian fusion cut. So everything is cut off except for the whiskers and what, the feet, the legs.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that would be, you know, if you have a dog that's just going to be a pet, this would be
perfect.
A way easier way to keep them. I mean, even the legs are long. That,
yep.
Right.
And some groomers, when they do the Asian fusion, they'll leave more hair, like, up here on the chest.
Okay, okay.
To bring down through the front.
Yes,
it's
yes.
It's kind of like the new thing, the new.
Okay,
it's almost like the new puppy cut.
Oh, okay.
Okay. I think it's the prettiest.
Well, yes. I think it's pretty.
Yes.
I really
yeah.
do.
Mm-hmm.
I don't play well with clippers.
Okay.
So that would be a little difficult for probably that kind of a cut. The way she's cut would be easier for me because it's right down.
Yes.
And just leave the legs.
Yes.
But to start getting into some of the other, I just don't play well
with clippers. Uh-huh. Yeah. But they are adorable.
Well, as a pet owner, I groom too, and I make it a point. It's the most fun the dog can have during the day. I say, you want to play? And they come, and they run, because we are going to have fun. I put them up on my kitchen counter. I spray them with detangler. I start combing. We sing. We giggle. We laugh. We have a good time.
Mm-hmm.
And the most important thing that you can do for this dog to keep it healthy and alive is to brush its teeth every day.
Yes.
The first thing to go is the teeth.
The teeth.
And you think, oh, bad breath, so what?
Mm-hmm.
No.
No.
It rots, they fall out, they're toothless. And if you have to have them done by a vet,
it
think hundreds,
yes.
maybe $1,500 twice a year, why not just brush? And they love the taste of the pet toothpaste. I use Pet Smile.
Mm-hmm.
They reach for it. They love it. They want to chew it. They want to brush with it. It's easy.
Mm-hmm.
You can do it, and it's worth 5 minutes of your time to save your dog's life.
You just have to get in a routine,
which
is
what you do.
When a puppy, too.
Yes, you
it
have
helps.
To start when it's a puppy. But,
just like,
of course, with a tiny little mouth, you probably do it with your finger first.
Yep.
you know, with a little gauze pad on, and you know, it's easy that way to get them used to it.
Right.
But she's used to it.
It's a toy dog problem, you know.
It is.
Most of the toy breeds lose their teeth.
That's a problem across every toy dog.
Yes.
Yeah, but they've got 42 teeth, 10 more than what people do, mm-hmm. and it's all in that little space.
Teeny mouth.
So it's all crammed tight, and the mm-hmm. food sticks. And many people don't know that some of the puppy teeth don't fall out. They have got sometimes two full sets of teeth.
Oh, my word.
And it rots both sets. Yeah. So you've got to have their dentals.
And it would be the same with their whiskers. You know, a lot of people think a whiskered dog is cute and don't think about food getting stuck in here.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's rotting, and the dog has bad breath, and you know, people just don't think very, very much.
No, I think, and also as far as the dental care goes, for generally for any dog, but what happens is once the teeth get full of tartar, that causes that irritation at the gum. So if you get to a point where it's affecting an infection, and the teeth are falling out because there's actually an infection there, you run the risk of losing your dog to a total systemic body infection.
It goes to the heart, the kidneys, the liver.
And mm-hmm. you know, I mean, mortifying for a pet owner.
Sure.
So if you need to take your dogs in for a dental, you're subjecting them to anesthesia as well.
Mm-hmm.
So for example, her coat is very long and beautiful. Now, if they were to take her in and have anesthesia, then they lose their coat.
Yes.
So it does come back eventually.
Yes,
but they lose their coat.
Yeah, but you have a bald dog there for a while.
Right.
For a while.
Right.
Now, I haven't heard any of them bark, not even once.
They are less likely to bark than a Yorkie.
Okay.
They have, and Karen can tell you, she can call my house, you can hear a pin drop.
Wow.
Until somebody knocks on the door.
Oh. Real guard dogs, right? Well, what did you say? You have 8, 10? I guess 10 little dogs running around, nipping at you would probably be, you know.
Yeah, I mean, you know, and I have a lot of dogs as well mixed with the show Havanese too, but, you know, Donna can call and they're quiet. Mine are fixated with the Amazon truck.
Oh.
So when they see
I wonder why.
We're on the end of the street, so when they see the dog come, the van go by, and then they'll all start barking because they think they're getting something.
Not only a little spoiled, right? So this actually would make a great dog for seniors or an apartment.
Absolutely.
You know, like in a senior community. This would be wonderful.
Yes.
It would. And I think that as a senior person or as a breeder, it's our obligation to look at, you know, where they live, how they live, what's their activity level, and then because some are wild. Scandal really would not do well in a quiet situation.
Oh, calms. She's too busy.
She's too busy. You know, some of the other ones, when Teresa's looking at, you know, her puppies, the temperament, their activity level, to try and match them with their owners.
Right.
And that's the way that I place my puppies.
Yes.
So I have had, in the history of all my breeding years, 30 years, I think I've only had one dog come back.
Mm-hmm.
And it really came back because the woman was fixated on a different puppy in the litter.
Oh.
The markings on a different puppy. So as the puppy got 6 months old, she just didn't, you know.
Yeah, decided she didn't want it.
Right.
Right.
So it was like, come back, it's fine.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, take the other dog.
Right. That's a good thing about breeders, they will always take back their puppies.
Our contracts, I'm pretty sure all of us do, that if you can't keep that dog, it comes back to me.
Right.
Right.
You know? And people don't understand about contracts either. You know, it's like, you have to sign a contract before you get one of my puppies. And it's like, what do you mean, you know?
Right.
The guy down the road didn't want one. So, but that's how you can tell a reputable breeder from people that are just breeding dogs.
Right. Right, and you know, also when you see them, the breeders that say they're raised in, you know, home raised, like for me, for Teresa, for Donna, these dogs live in the house. They're not in a kennel situation in the basement,
right?
Where they will bring the female up a week before she's due to have her puppies, and put her in, you know, the box in the house, and then the puppies are running and,
yes,
you know,
yes,
oh, okay, you know, but
right,
then as soon as she's done nursing,
back in the basement,
right,
she goes
back to the kennel. She goes.
Yes, yes. Yes.
And I think, you know, it makes it, it really does make a difference.
Makes a,
oh my
happy
gosh,
a puppy.
And the temperament of the puppy.
Well, they're so used to being with humans at that point. You
yes
know, I mean, for the last 8 weeks, 12 weeks, they've been with you in the house, hearing house noises.
And they're socialized with the other dogs in
mm-hmm
the home.
Mm-hmm.
So they're a much happier puppy,
right,
because
right
they are socialized with people
and
other
dogs.
Dogs.
That's exactly right.
And children, too, if
yes
possible.
Yes, and children.
Yes, yes. Are they good with kids?
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Are they? Okay. Because you think
it.
A little dog, obviously, you don't sell to anybody
well, you have to
with less than a 5-year-old.
You have to make sure the child knows the best way to handle. I tell them,
mm-hmm,
you sit on the floor.
Mm-hmm.
Right. You can
mm-hmm
hold the puppy if you sit on the floor.
Right.
And so things like that, that because you want them to be safe. But other than that, the children, they're just, you
yeah
know, they're wonderful pets for
very
children.
Very good, very good. So what health problems do you have with this breed?
Same as for a Yorkie.
So pretty much.
Yeah. Liver shunt, collapsing trachea.
So, not so much liver shunt in this breed, though. We haven't had it.
I've seen a lot of beavers with this shunts. If they're
really
small, the smaller the puppy, often they have.
We don't know what a shunt is. We have no idea what you're talking about.
Sorry,
that's okay.
For Yorkshire Terriers, many of them are born with a. Well, when they're in utero, the puppies have their mothers have the liver that processes the blood,
mm-hmm,
cleans the blood, and after they're born, the shunt around that closes. It's supposed to. It doesn't always. And if it doesn't,
okay,
the puppy doesn't have a liver. Now, there
okay
are different kinds. Some
mm
are operable. Some are MVD multiples of hundreds or thousands of little straws going down through what would have been the liver, and you can't operate on that. So
uh-huh
you have to have a bile acid test done on the puppy to be sure it doesn't have a liver
okay
shunt.
Okay.
It's important.
Right, right.
But you can't have that done until they're older.
Yeah.
You can have it done. It's a blood test. You can. I mean,
right,
they just.
No, the blood test. She meant the surgery, I assume.
No, I'm saying the test is not.
Oh, okay. You can't do it on an 8-week-old.
From what I'm saying is
yeah
you can't do it on an 8-week-old puppy. It's
right
not going to give you correct numbers.
Because you have to wait for all the toxins to sort of build up, and then the dog gets sick.
Yes.
So when they
okay
get sick, then they're going into the vet, and the vet's going to do
yes
a full blood panel,
mm-hmm,
and then they're going to do a special panel of blood draw
okay
where they'll run specific tests
mm-hmm
for the liver.
Mm-hmm.
And usually from those results, depending on how high they are, they may try to manage a shunt with diet. So
and okay.
Diet,
so
and
it doesn't
medication
always mean surgery.
It does not.
They okay
can, some depending on how severe
mm-hmm
the numbers look, which really is reflective of how long has it gone on.
Yes.
You know, is it a 7-month-old puppy
mm-hmm
that's ill? Is it, you know, now a 5-year-old dog who's been perfectly fine and then gets ill? But
mm-hmm
they give medication, and they will try to manage with a diet.
Okay.
Low
okay
protein.
Yeah.
Very
yeah
low protein. So,
very low protein.
Yes.
So that would be the same with a couple of other breeds too that have
right
like kidney problems or
yes,
yeah,
exactly.
Right, right.
And you know, sometimes the dog can go on and live a normal
mm-hmm,
you know,
mm-hmm
a normal healthy life.
Yes.
As long as it's managed. And you just have to make sure that
right
you're following the guidelines.
Mm-hmm. So is that the only problem that
there are other problems. We have, just like any toy dog would have, patella issues
okay,
if they're
that's
jumping
slipping,
off
right
stuff. And
slipping
you,
kneecaps.
Yes. You,
okay.
And, but if you let your dog jump off the couch, that's a possibility
right
that you could cause that. The
right
dog could get problems with their patella.
Right.
There is some dogs with seizures out there from the very old lines. We're trying to
okay
navigate away from those
yes, yes,
breed
yes
lines, and we're doing very well with that.
Good,
so,
good.
Matter of fact, that was what I was saying we were talking about last night on the health board.
Yes,
so,
yes.
So we are seeing much, much lower numbers with
mm-hmm
that.
Good.
So that's good.
Good, yeah. Yeah, and that's the only thing. You know, breeders are so interested in the health of their breeds, because you're going to be showing your dog in the breed ring.
Right.
Well, if you have a problem with your breed, your dog is epileptic, well, that's going to get around.
Right.
So, you know, mm-hmm. you try to breed the best to the best.
Well, and you breed, you test, we all, and I think all of us reputable breeders, mm-hmm. test our bitches before. And our studs
yes.
before we breed. We make sure that there's nothing in those, in the test that mm-hmm. is negative mm-hmm. or that could cause a problem, or that the two, the mom and dad, don't have
right.
two of the same genes that yes. could cause a
yes.
problem.
Yes, that's exactly so right. That's exactly right.
So they do the DNA testing uh-huh. through Embarker.
Yes.
Mars.
Mars. Yeah. I've used yeah. both.
Mm-hmm. And UC Davis.
UC Davis, yes.
Doing
yes.
A, yes. a study to separate things out with them.
We uh-huh. did a study with UC Davis early on.
Yeah.
For dwarf syndrome in these dogs,
oh.
and we found that that is not part of
yes.
our breed, which
right.
is
right.
good.
Right.
So,
right.
and we try to, you know, as the health board, we're trying to better mm-hmm. get better knowledge mm-hmm. of the breed for our
right.
for
right.
people.
So I want to ask each one of you, why did you get this?
I seen this dog in 1997. And said, that's the dog for me.
Teresa?
Well, I've been breeding and showing Yorkshire Terriers
okay.
for 30 years. And when I saw pictures of this breed, I just fell in love.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I love the combination of the black and white.
Yes.
And
they're very striking.
You know, and they're
yeah.
still similar to Yorkshire Terriers,
yes.
so that it's still... Kind, you know, it
sort of, sort
me,
of
it,
like, yes,
you know, brought me in,
right,
and
Marilyn?
So I finally, okay. you know, did
but get
to,
one, yes,
get one, and you know, breed to a beautiful champion,
mm-hmm.
and so this is my first litter.
Your first
so
litter,
very,
oh wow,
very
congratulations
about this new
yes.
adventure,
yes. And Marilyn, why'd you get one?
Well, you know, we've had Yorkies for many years.
Yes.
We started a Yorkshire Terrier rescue 20 years
mm-hmm.
ago. One of our events, a lady came to the rescue event, and she had a stroller. She was pushing a stroller, and she opened the lid, and inside were two of the most beautiful, tiny, little dogs that had golden white faces and black and white. And we all said, how beautiful. What are they? Is that a Shih Tzu, or what is
uh-huh.
that? Oh, no, she said, this is a party Yorkie. I said,
oh.
a party Yorkie, never heard, didn't know.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
then years later when I wanted to get another dog, I thought, what about one of those party Yorkies? I looked them up, but they weren't calling them party Yorkies,
mm-hmm.
they were calling them beavers.
Yeah.
So that's
how you got yours.
And we
right.
got one from the foremost
mm-hmm.
breeders in the country,
mm-hmm.
Millie Smith. My husband flew to Indiana
mm-hmm.
and brought her home on a
yeah.
plane.
Yeah, and Stephanie?
I have a breeder friend of mine that has them, and when I first saw one, I just...
You had to have one. Yes. And Karen?
I have a friend who had them and had a litter, and I wasn't doing anything, and I helped transport the dog from New Jersey to Mass because the people that purchased it from her lived in Mass. And when she came, she brought both boys,
mm-hmm.
and I was like, oh my God, I love that boy. And I had to take them anyway home, and so the other family fell through, and the one family came and got their dog.
Oh.
And Hennessy's still in my house.
Yes.
But he's a finished champion. I think he's one of, or the first, Biewer Terrier to actually get a placement in the toy group.
Oh, wow. Very
and
good.
And my granddaughter was the one that was showing him that
wonderful.
Day, and she did a
wonderful.
Great job. And,
yeah, very good.
And someone wanted to breed him to him,
mm-hmm.
and so that's how I got Scandal. She was
yes.
a puppy back
yes.
from
yes.
that.
Very good.
So, but I mean, I've been breeding Havanese
mm-hmm.
forever.
For years.
Had Wheaton
yes.
Terriers prior to that.
Very good. So it's with any breed. You fall in love with it, you got to have one. But thank you all, ladies.
Thank you, Pat.
Very informative program. And I just love them. I'm not a small dog person, but gosh darn, they're cute. I'd probably step on it the first day. But anyhow, so thank you again. And if you want any more information about the beavers, just give the Kennel Club a call, and I will put you in touch with one of these ladies. So for this evening, good night.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Pat.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.